Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we are checking out the Rockwood 2902WS Ultralight. This half-ton towable trailer behind me is a couple's coach that can also fit a couple grandkids. So it's a rear kitchen model, and it also has some really cool features. This is a Rockwood, so that means it's gonna be your cream of the crop as far as travel trailer ultralights go. This is the number one selling travel trailer that's fiberglass out there. And I'll tell you a few reasons why. We're gonna go over the outside, and then we're gonna go over the inside. A few reasons why this is a very popular model. Rockwood is a vacuum bonded fiberglass wall. That means that this is going to last a lot longer. It's not going to delaminate. And then this is a fully aluminum constructed camper. So all the floor, the sidewalls, the roof has aluminum versus wood, so it's not going to rot out on you. Also, this has a drop frame. So most travel trailers do not have this big of a pass-through storage area. It's about half this size. The reason why they can get away with this is because what they do is they drop the I-beams down right here to give you this huge storage spot in the front. We're going to start on the rear of the coach here. I want to show you a few things. One, it does have the outside shower with both hot and cold water. It's at a spot where it's a little bit more on the front side of the coach as far as right by the door as opposed to on the back side, which can be helpful. Also, this is a black tank flush, so you can flush out your entire sewer system. An easy way to work your antifreeze into your system. That's important. I was talking to a guy just yesterday. He's like, yeah, I was messing with my water pump and I broke off my inlet to my water pump because it was too tight and he couldn't get the hose off. This solves that problem by just having to flip a valve to get your antifreeze in the system. You also have very easy access to all your stuff, like your water pump, your 10,000 gallon water filtration system that filters all the water in the entire unit, as well as your bypass valves for your water heater. Easy access for all of that in one location. This is your water heater. It's a gas electric DSI, meaning direct spark ignition. You have buttons on the inside of the coach that you can push to make this work instead of having to come out here and light it. It will give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. Right here is just a storage spot. You'll notice that these are all magnetic hooks. That way you don't have to worry about those plastic clips breaking over time. And this is a great spot to put your chalk blocks or your outside grill. That all comes with it. So this is what the outside grill looks like with it all set up. You'll also notice you have outside speakers, the frameless windows, so you don't have that weird piece of rubber right here that can dry out and leak over time. Awning lights all the way across. Power awning. This is a Dometic power awning. That means it goes in and out about twice as fast. Let me show you what that does. Extend awning. So I'll go ahead and retract that. If you're looking at another camper, watch how slow it goes in. It's about half the speed compared to this one. This is one of the fastest ones in the industry. Large grab assist handle. This has multiple purpose. One, just to get into the coach very easily. Also, if you have little kiddos or something like that hanging out with you this time, you can block the door so that adults can get out but not kids. Three-step entry as opposed to a two-step entry. This gives you that extra height to be able to get into the coach easily, as well as gives you that extra ground clearance. This has the Torflex suspension system. The Torflex suspension system is an independent suspension system that has a 10-year warranty on it. Aluminum rims, and then these are the Easy Lube axles. And basically that Torflex system is three rubber rods that kind of move inside, and that's going to be easier on your camper because you can imagine everything's getting twisted and turned as you're going down those roads, and having a nice suspension system will keep everything in the same spot as far as all your camping gear, as well as the coach itself and the frame. It's going to be a lot easier on it. Couple other things to show you. One, it does come with a table that you can set all your meats and veggies out on. It has a spot to put a small outside TV if you want. This is the awning where you can adjust these. So if you want the rain to come this way, you can do that by just adjusting these arms. There's one on each side. Also, there's a hookup for your TV antenna. So if you do put your TV here, you have both a power outlet as well as the antenna outlet right there. You have stabilizer jacks that are electric. There's a manual override if you need to, but you just push a button for this to go up and down. Makes the job a little bit easier. Over here, you do have two 30-pound tanks. Diamond plate on the front. This is where all your mud and rocks and everything's gonna hit, so it's protecting your fiberglass by having something nice and sturdy down here. You also have a solar plug. This is a ZAMP solar plug. You can plug any solar panel into it as long as you have the right connector. You do need to make sure that the solar panel that you plug in has a controller built onto it so that you don't mess up your batteries and don't overheat them. You also have a light on this power tongue jack with a manual override, so that way you can see what you're doing. And then this part lights up as well, so this just makes it look nice as you're going down the road, as well as some extra lights to compensate for this light as well. Underneath here, there is a battery disconnect. There's a little red key. It looks like this. And that red key basically disconnects the batteries from all the power in the system. So if you accidentally left your light on, things like your propane leak detector, other things like the radio, will draw down that battery. So if you left your camper in storage for a week and then came back to it, your battery's gonna be dead. But with that battery disconnect, you don't have to worry about that. Instead of having to take the straps off the box and then disconnect the negative, you can do it all just from the pull of a key. For the weights of this camper, this has a dry weight of 6,867 pounds, and it has a GVWR of 8,764. So again, probably that's most likely gonna be pulled by a half-ton truck or better. This is your docking light, by the way, to turn on that light right up on the front. Speaking of other things on this, as far as specs go, this has a 90-gallon gray water capacity. That is huge. That means even if you have city water connections at your campsite, which a lot of places maybe have just the water, but they don't have the dumps, your gray water tank or the water from your sink and shower is gonna fill up a lot faster than your black tank, which is your toilet shower, toilet water. The toilet has a 45-gallon tank to it. The fresh water is a 43-gallon tank. So you can fill that up if you need to, but if you're feeling like you're getting pretty close to your weight limits or you just don't want to pull that extra weight, that's where that 10,000-gallon water filtration system comes in. It's residential grade, rated down to 0.9 microns. So that way you're not having to worry about putting contaminated water in your tanks and lines. Over here, you do have your cable satellite in, so that if you wanted to put a satellite dish out here or the campsite has cable, you can hook into it right here. Also, this is where your sewer drain waste is located. This is one of the tanks, and then your galley tank is on the backside. They split those up so that you don't have to worry about having a long tube that connects into one tank, and then that tube, you know, being so long that problems happen. So they've done this a smart way. Also, this is a fully enclosed and heated underbelly. This has 12-volt heat pads on the tanks themselves that are rated down to negative 11 degrees. On the backside here, you have a 30-amp connector. This has a little blue LED light that lights up once you're plugged in with the cord that comes with the coach. That is really nice, because if you have a power pedestal and you're not getting power to your camper, you can troubleshoot a lot easier or know that you have this connected in right as soon as this lights up. You also have a rear ladder so that you can access your roof. That's super important. One, to just be able to check all your things on top of the roof to make sure everything's good to go. And if there's something that lands on your slide out, it's important that you look up there and clean that off before you slide that slide in in. This is also a TPO Superflex roof. That means it's 30% less rubber, it's lighter weight, it's more resistant to abrasion. It's got a 12-year warranty on it. It doesn't send those chalky black streaks down the side of your coach, and you don't have to maintenance it like you do an EPDM or a normal rubber roof. So that's a lot of benefit to going to this type of roof. You also have a hard shell for the spare tire instead of a fabric-y one that's gonna look ratty in about 2 years. Let's go inside and check out what's in there. All right, come on in, guys. Check out this Rockwood Ultra Lite 2902WS. Like I mentioned, this is a rear kitchen. It has a super slide on one side, and then this is kind of an ideal floor plan for a lot of people because, you know, sometimes this is a great couples coach, but it's also a great friends coach. So like if you have some friends that you want to invite over that you met at the campsite or whatever, there's plenty of seating for everybody to have a conversation. You could even pull up, you know, an extra dinette table and you could even move this table as soon as you unscrewed it from the floor, and you can move all this furniture around for a giant area just to hang out. You could fit a lot of people in this one area. Also, this floor plan lends itself to a great deal of counter space and cabinetry. So you can see there is a beautiful cabinet. This is a cool, this is a tabletop extension. So let me show you what that does. I'll pull this out. So this has two little brackets right here. These are solid surface countertops. And this hooks right here. Go ahead and do that. And then this comes down. See if I remember how to do this. Now you have even more counter space to work with. And this is cool. This little light inside here is a motion detector. So as soon as you open it up, that light turns on. This is a cutting board. Also, it's flush to give you, and also the stovetop is flush to give you the maximum amount of counter space. Stainless steel sink instead of a plastic one, so you're not gonna have to worry about melting through it with your pots and pans or scarring it in some way. Pull down sink faucet. This has a knife rack in the back here, so that you can store some things there, as well as this folds up to the side. Also, I wanted to show you one more thing. When I rock this camper, you'll notice that nothing moves other than maybe this little guy here, as far as all of the shades go. They're all super quiet. That's, you know, not a big deal maybe at first, but after you're in the camper for 2 days, it starts to get annoying after all the shades are like banging against each other. These are the one of the only types of shades that don't make a lot of noise when you're walking in the camper. Now, I don't have the stabilizer jacks down right now, so that would of course help, but you know, every little thing that Rockwood does, they've thought about it a lot, and it really shows. A couple other things I want to show you. This is a 22-inch oven. So the 17-inch ovens that you would normally see in here, this bottom rack right here comes to about right here. And so you can imagine that's about twice as much stuff that you can fit in this one compared to other ones. Ball bearing metal glide drawers that they pull out all the way so that you can get maximum usage. This is a spot for like your scrubby brush. More storage right over here. And that's of course, and then of course all your upper storage too. These cabinetry, all the cabinetry on the inside here, they are all pocket screwed together. They're not stapled together. That is a much better way to do things because as you're bumping down the road, these tiles right here, they become loose. And even just opening and shutting the door several times, hundreds of times over its life, this part gets loose. So this is a this is going to be a better way to keep this door together. Also, this is a raised panel cabinetry. A lot of them, they're going to go to like a flat panel, and that's not nearly as nice. It doesn't sound as solid, so it kind of makes that boing sound every time you open and shut it. This one won't do that. It's a lot more solid. Also, I want to point out, this is CoachNet. Every single Forest River camper that we sell brand new comes with CoachNet. This is 24/7 roadside assistance, and you can call them and say, hey, I'm in the middle of Timbuktu and my whatever is not working. You can call them up and they can tell you where the nearest Forest River dealership is. They can give you hints on great camping spots. They can tell you all kinds of stuff. They have a nice concierge service. All that's included for 1 year with your brand new coach. Okay, well, last thing to point out is this is a gas electric refrigerator. That means you can be able to use this even if you're at the Walmart parking lot with no hookups or out in the middle of the boonies, or if you're pulled off to the side of the road at a truck stop, you don't have to worry about your food spoiling like you would an electric fridge. An electric fridge is great if you're going to keep the camper in one spot all the time. But if you're actually going to be moving with food, which is almost all the time, that's the whole point of a camper, is to be able to move with your mini home, right? This one can pull that off. This is a countertop that comes out, so if you need a little bit of extra space, it has a little hook right here, and you can give yourself extra elbow space. You also have storage underneath the chairs, so if you want to be able to store a deck of cards or a sewing kit, they're all four do that. One of the things I wanted to make note about the roof. One, it is a bowed roof or a barreled roof. That's super nice just to make this room feel a little bit more open. But two, it means there's no standing water on top of the roof, which is super important because water is not your friend when it comes to leaks and campers. Another thing that's really important to note is this is one of the only roofs built like this out there in the industry. This has some of the most high-tech engineering behind it. What they do is, this is an aluminum roof truss system, but inside there it's all vacuum bonded. Most roof systems are like a truss system where they have like a stud, and then you go maybe a foot or two and then another stud, and so you have soft spots every time you don't have a stud there. This is one solid piece of block foam surrounded by Luon or wood on both sides that's all pressed together and held in a stacker press or a vacuum bonding press. So that's really cool. All right, over to the entertainment system. I wanted to show you, one, that this does pull out and it's on a swivel arm. Also, this bracket right here is the same bracket that's on the outside of the coach. So if you wanted to put this outside, you are able to do that. Also, there's a little button. This is a tip for once you buy the coach so that you don't drain your battery. This is a button that will give you a power boost to your TV antenna. So on, off. Make sure you have that off. That's one of those things that could drain your battery really fast if you left it in storage for a week or so. This stereo system is nice. It controls the inside speakers as well as the outside speakers. And it also has Bluetooth and HDMI. A USB with a charging port on it, so if you wanted to put your phone here and charge up your phone, you can do that. Over here, this is your control panel for everything. It has your monitors for your tanks. Slide outs are all individual. Instead of having one button to control the slides, you have individual ones, which is not always the case. You can turn on most of your main lights through here, and then all the individual lights are, so if you're sitting down here reading your book and you want a light, you can do that with just a push of the button. Same with over here on this couch. These are actually movable lights, which are kind of nice, and you just push the light themselves to turn them on and off. A little bit of storage underneath here. And then another thing that's really cool is this has a Wi-Fi ranger built into it. What that does is your cell phone has a little tiny antenna to be able to reach maybe, you know, your local whatever Wi-Fi hotspot. This is a big antenna that's on top of your roof. That is super cool because that means you could have your laptop in here and connect to the router that's built into this system here, and maybe you only had one bar of Wi-Fi signal reaching it from here. All of a sudden now you have 10 different places to connect to, and they all have full bars. So it's a very big difference by turning that on, and that's just a push of a button to do that. All right, moving on to the hallway and bathroom. This actually has some sink counter space, which is kind of nice. And then you'll notice how big this sink is compared to anything else that you'll see out there. This one, you can actually fit both hands in there, wash your face, and you're not getting water everywhere. Also, toothbrush, soap holder, wood medicine cabinet, LED lights that are just turned on and off by the switch of a button, and then a high-powered max air vent fan. You know, it's funny, this camper has so many different things on it. I was working with a guy yesterday who had a Rockwood, and he was trying to upgrade to a fifth wheel that wasn't a Rockwood, and he pointed out 20 different things. He's like, man, and he said, my camper has, I wish they would have put a max air vent fan. I wish they would have done this. He had like a list of 20 things, and I'm like, man, is this guy even gonna trade in? Because Rockwood is really hard to beat as far as feature, construction, all of that. So yeah, that just was a testimony to me of how good Rockwood's able to do that. Anyway, that max air vent fan has a cover over it. It moves over 900 cubic feet of air per minute. You can crack a window and open up a window and create up to a 10 mile per hour breeze through your camper just with that on. That is gonna save you from having to run your AC as much. It's also gonna help your AC because you can get all that hot air out of here in a hurry. As you can see, I have plenty of room in here to move around. This is a magnetic strip right here to close the door. And then I also have the extra room right here for height. I'm about 5'11", so you can see I have plenty of room to work. Also, this bed or this bathroom is a Jack and Jill bathroom. And just show you, there is more storage here. So that means that you can either access the bathroom through the hallway or right through here, through the bedroom. Also, this whole deal right here, instead of the slide out being just for the bedroom, this is a wardrobe slide out. It goes all the way over to the linen closet as well. So there is a sliding door right here that you can close. And then these are actually pretty nice. So you have hanging storage right there. And you'll notice that they didn't cheapen up the cabinetry once they left the kitchen. So a lot of times you'll look for that nice cabinetry and then you're like, oh, it has it. And you're looking at the kitchen. And then all of a sudden, by the time you get to in here, it's not the same cabinetry. Good spots for like towels and shoes and whatever. This extends all the way out so you can reach all the way over to here if you need to. And then you have storage all above here as well. Storage over on the sides. And then this whole part right here lifts up. And then you have three more drawers underneath here, as well as a big spot above the drawers to put like your blankets, pillows, all that. And notice how all this is aluminum, not wood. So this is, again, something that Rockwood does fairly, I think, exclusively. I've not seen another coach do this yet. If you look underneath here, all this is wood, and about 30% of the time there's a bowed piece of wood because the strut couldn't hold the 2x2 that they put on there, and it's already broke before it even left the showroom floor. So that is again just a nice testament to Rockwood. This is a I believe it's a Denver mattress. Let me double check. No, Serta mattress. So it's an actual mattress, not some kind of off-brand. And you have a second high-powered max air vent fan in here. So if you want to be able to cool this area down in a hurry without the noise of an AC, you can do that. You also have a TV back here, a TV backer back here. So if you want to add a bedroom TV, you can. It also has the bedroom satellite in over here too. A lot of times that is not included. They'll have the satellite hookup for the living room, but not into the bedroom. So that's a nice feature too. Also, you have power outlets. So you have a charging center with 12 volt, two USBs, and a 110 outlet, as well as a second 110 outlet over there. And then you have individual lights to control right here. And then again, nice natural light as well, and a nice shelf to work with too. That's your day shade. That's your nightshade. And then above us, I wanted to point out that you have bedroom speakers. So that stereo system controls the living room speakers, the bedroom speakers, and the outside speakers. All can work in conjunction with each other or separately. And then this is your ducting for your air conditioning. So not only do you have this fan, but you have four ducts inside the bedroom to cool down the unit more evenly throughout the entire coach. A lot of coaches, they'll have one duct that kind of zigzags, which is less efficient, and you'll have hot spots and cold spots in your camper, whereas this is gonna work a lot better. So thanks for checking out this Rockwood 2902WS here at the Great Outdoors RV. You can subscribe, you can also like it. It really helps me out if you like it. And also, if you like this, you should check out our website, www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, and check out the Rockwood 2707WS. It's a very similar floor plan with a rear kitchen, but it has opposing slide outs in the back, and you might like that one as well. Comment down below, let me know which one you like better, this one or the 2707WS. Our phone number, 970-313-4337, or you can just come and visit us here at Evans, Colorado. We'd love to say hi to you. And then we have 200 other campers on our website as well of different floor plans and designs. We can also special order any of our lines that we carry. We also have financing. We also can take trade-ins, you name it. We'd love to help you out. Have a great day, guys. Thanks.